Hi everyone, and welcome to my third Flosstube video. I'm super excited to be doing this again. Every week I'm looking so forward to this moment where I can just sit down and show off what I've been doing this week. Today is Saturday the 24th. It's almost Christmas and I can't believe it's finally here. I love Christmas. The Christmas tree is nice and the presents have been looking very inviting. And I'm looking forward to having Christmas breakfast tomorrow morning with my family, with my parents and my sisters, and then having just two whole days, because we do 2 days of Christmas here in Europe, like most countries do 2 days of Christmas, so Sunday and Monday, 2 days full of fun and games and just enjoying time together. So I'm just gonna do a quick little update before Christmas and everyone goes away to enjoy their time with family. I'm going to show you some of my progress this week, and I'm going to show you my last, I think, 7 WIPs it is, to round out my 24 WIP rotation, all the works I have in progress, show you the final batch of those, and then finally I will do some shoutouts, talk to you about my plans for the coming week. And I have a little bit of a change in the coming week, but I'll talk about that later. And what more? No, basically that's it. And if I have anything else to say, I will probably get to it. So first of all, I want to start off with yes, yes, yes. So, like, I want to hear some drums, and I need to find it in my box. Where is it? All the way in the bottom. I have a finish! Yay! I went from 25 to 24 WIPs because I finished my little hedgehog. I don't know if you remember, but last time I told you that I'd run out of the ecru for this little pattern. And I walked into a craft store. Usually I don't buy DMC here because DMC here is 145 a skein, 1 euro 45 a skein, which is insanely expensive. Usually I buy it online, like Sue and So. British Pound is a little bit cheaper. They are like 96 pence, which is 110 euros. I don't know exactly, but I buy them online. Or when someone I know goes to the States, I send a list with them to get me like 100 flosses of DMC, but I didn't have ecru, and I walked in the store and I decided to fork over the 145 for the ecru so I can finish this little guy. So this Woodland Creatures set kit that I got with Cross Stitcher magazine October 2014, both of them are finished, so I consider this one WIP done, down to 24 WIPs. Super excited, yay! And you will find out a little bit about why I'm so excited to go down to 24 in just a sec. Second, I want to show you 2 hoops I got. I normally stitch in hand, so I don't really use hoops because I just stitch in hand with no cue snaps, no hoops whatsoever. But I saw these in just a random budget store and they were very cheap, so I decided to pick them up. I have no clue as to what diameter they are, but they look fun. Maybe I'll use them, maybe I don't. It looks especially handy on bigger pieces where I usually sit with my legs up so that my fabric is leaning against my legs so I can stitch two-handed. This doesn't always work. Like sometimes I'm at work working on it and it's not really good looking when you sit with your feet up on a chair to support the back of your cross stitching work. So maybe for those times I can use a lovely pink purple hoop. And I also have this tiny one if I want to do some ornaments or something. So yes, got some hoops. Finally, the first piece of haul. And then I want to show you the one other project I worked on this week. As you may remember from my last video, I'm working on Red Barn by Design Works for my grandmother's birthday, and I'm going to show you how far along I am at this point. I left everything for the rest downstairs. So this is where it is right now. Over 75% finished. It smells a little bit like fries. It's been downstairs when we fried some stuff couple days before and it smells like fries. Oh, I really need to give it a wash. Okay, so this is the whole piece. 75% done. I'm really, really pleased with how far I am and how it looks. I was not liking this kit in the beginning. I'm gonna be honest. I was dreading it because it was so many green. Sorry, there's something in my eye. There was so many green. I hated every bit of it. Like, working on it was a nightmare. I thought I was never ever going to like working on it, and I thought it was going to end up as a UFO. But then I decided to start cross-stitching on it actively to make it a gift for my grandmother. My grandmother's birthday is in 4 days. It's December 28th, and I really want to give it for her birthday. But this morning I came to a point, yes, I come this far, but when yesterday evening I was finishing up a little section here, 300 stitches or something, I thought at 11, okay, this is going to be done in an hour. I put down my needle at 2 o'clock. I had stitched for 3 full hours to finish that little piece in the corner, and I was like, okay, I'm not being realistic that I'm going to finish this whole entire quarter, 25% of the chart, because then I hadn't done any of this. Okay, I'll show you a little bit of a close-up, by the way. I don't know, like a little bit of the... just so you can see that it's actually kind of pretty. So much more prettier than I thought. Anyway, I continued with this part, like the flower part here this morning. Still stitching, still trying frantically to get as much stitches in as I could. And then at lunch, I was sitting with my family at the table and I was like, okay, gotta be realistic. I'm not gonna finish this before my grandmother's birthday on the 28th. I have only half a day left today, then Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday, but then on Tuesday my boyfriend's coming over and I generally don't stitch when he's here because we don't really spend so much time together always. I mean, I haven't seen him for 12 days now, 11 days when he comes over, so I'm not going to be stitching. I don't want to be stitching all day when he's here. So I'm gonna just work on it if I can, but I want to just enjoy this Christmas with my family, and I don't want to lock myself out of the family dynamic by sitting in a corner on the couch and stitching. I mean, I can talk, but and I can watch TV, and it's fine, but I just want to be engaged. I mean, Christmas is one of the few times in the year where you can actively do something with your family. Everyone's home, everyone's in a fun mood, so I just don't want to waste it. I say this quotation marks. I don't want to waste a Christmas like this. I hope this makes sense. So I've decided to just work on it if I can, if I have time, and then wrap it for my grandmother anyway, because I'm going to be going to her on the 28th anyway. Wrap it for her, maybe find a frame if I can, show it to her and show her how far I got and what she can be expecting, and then finish it, hopefully finish it before my own birthday, which is the 9th of January. She's coming over on the 8th of January, so I should definitely have it finished by then, and then I can give it to her framed. I'm okay with this. I'm not going to stress. I mean, it's not going to get more prettier if I stress about finishing it, so it is what it is, and stitching always takes longer than you think. Oh, I pulled out the needle. Brilliant. Brilliant, Jay. Luckily, I still have it. Wouldn't be my first needle I lost. So, basically, the hedgehog and the barn is the only two things I worked on this week. For good reason, because, you know, I wanted to have it finished, but then life. So, I'm going to continue with, let me see, yes, I did the first three things on my list. I'm going to continue with my remaining WIPs, and I think it's 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, 8. 8 WIPs. So there we go. I'm going to do it fairly quickly because there's lots of other things I still have to do today. I'm going to start with the final kit in my dome series. I showed you last time the Korean clothes and the Japanese clothes. But this is... oh, wait. Sorry for the glare. Which way? Okay, this is my computer screen. Yes, better. This is Indian clothes. It's similar as it has the woman and the man. Again, just different set of clothing. I really like these sets. This is the one I'm furthest along with because I decided to focus on it for a little bit. And it's really starting to look like something. Okay, put the needle in. Like, I always leave these things hanging, like, loosely off the back of my work, which is fine, except for when you're showing them. So, this is how far I've got. I started on the woman again. Like, I think I know that I always stitch on the right side of the middle first. So, I got furthest along. I did some of the forehead, pretty much finished all of this here except for some here on the top. I had to frog out this entire section last time I worked on it, from here all the way down to there, one when I had just done one of the purples, because I was one stitched off here in the middle. So this was not fun, but it looks good now. I'm good to go now, and I can't wait to continue on this, because it's really nice. The colors are really gorgeous. I really like these kits. Okay, get everything back in. Last week I also spent some time organizing my WIP box. I have a big black box where all my projects fit exactly in. And I went to go to the supermarket to get some of these deep freezer bags, like the big ones, so I can store my projects in them. Okay, the next one I have is, now, which one do I show you? This one. Sorry, I just like want to have them in order. Yes. The next one is a Dimensions Gold Petites kit. And it's called Cozy Cub. I'm just getting everything out. Sorry for the wrinkling again. It is Cozy Cub. I love these Dimensions Petites kit. I know not everyone's a fan of the Dimensions brand. I'm not going to get into this. I bought these and I'm going to stitch them. I really like this. And I'm thinking about giving it to my mother. She's born in the year of the tiger. The Chinese Zodiac's astrology calendar. She was born in the year of the tiger, and just seems like a nice little gift for her birthday. And her birthday is March 11th, so I think I have time enough to finish this, because, oh wait, oh, needle, like, why am I always missing needles? There should be a needle in here and there isn't. Okay, I'm gonna worry about this later. Anyway, this is how far I am with this one. This entire down section, finished. Like, entirely done. And then the top section, most of the face is done, and I'm just filling in some things here. And I think it should be done by the time I come around to March 11th. Like, I like this. I mean, these kits are, I believe, under 15 euros, and they are so nice, and you have so long to work on them, and for 15 euros, this is really good. I hope I'll find the needle. Maybe I'll just grab it out for another project, hopefully. Okay, so this is the freezer bags I mentioned. So I wrote the name of the kit on here, and it's in a mirror image because, you know, my phone. I don't know, is it mirroring back around? Anyway, you either see this in mirror or normal, I don't know. I see it in mirror in my screen. And they have this zippy thing so I can close them up. Because I was having all these, I was keeping them in the original packaging at first. But then some of them are ripping, and this is just easiest. I know floss won't fall out. So the next one I have is a kit by Busilla I bought on eBay for super cheap. And it's called Bath Time, and it's adorable. I love cats. I love most animals in general, but I love cats. I have two of myself, and then we have a third cat in the house right now because my sister's home for Christmas, and she always brings her cat because Elsa has to stay alone for a long time because now she's staying for a week and a half, so we have three cats in the house. It's really nice. her cat is a house cat, so he doesn't go outside, so we don't have any problems with him being here. And he comes here often. He comes here about twice a month for a weekend. So anyway, I showed you the picture again because I was rambling. This kit was a nightmare to sort out. I'm still not sure if I picked the right colors. And I, for some reason, I think I might be mixing some colors because these flosses were not in a thread cart when I got them. They were just haphazardly piled together and I had to figure out which one was which. And it says again, it says things like pale periwinkle, light periwinkle, dark periwinkle, and then dusty gray. Okay, listen to this. Pale dusty gray, light dusty gray, pale gray, dark gray, darkest gray. Well, sorry, I don't know the difference between all of these. And I still don't know, and I hope I'm doing it right. I mean, especially because, for example, the pale gray, the gray, have the same amount of yards, like the same amount of threads. So I hope I'm doing good. This is a nightmare. Anyway, sorry, I was just looking at the amount of grays that were in there. I figured that I would just go, and if it looked a little bit weird, I would just frog it. But so far it looks okay. I mean, I switched two colors, but it's not too bad. Let me see how this, which direction this goes. Okay, it goes like this. This is how far I've gotten. This is the, okay, just let me fold it differently. Yes. This is the tail of, this is the butt of the cat, and this is the reflection on the fishbowl that he's in, that he's washing himself in. So I think I got along pretty well. I mean, this is all half cross stitch in the bowl to give this reflection. So this is quick, and this is the rest of the tail coming down here. So it's nice. Again, all my WIPs don't have so much work. I explained in one of my earlier videos that I did for when I started all of my projects that I hadn't yet started, which was, I did this about 3 or 4 months ago. I decided to create a 2-hour rotation for each project. So on some of these projects, I just worked for 4 hours. So this is why I'm not so far along with all of them. But I'll get into a new rotation a little bit today and then some more next video. Okay, the next one I have is by one of my favorite designers, and that's Soda Stitch. I think I have the most patterns by them in my stash. And a series I really like is the fairy tale kind of series where they do blocks for a specific book or fairy tale. This is the Anne of Green Gables one. I've read Anne of Green Gables. I mean, I'm not super in love with the book, but I know the characters, and I think of all of them, this would be my least favorite, but it's still super duper adorable. And this is something the stash queen Katie also mentioned in her video. I've been rewatching her videos, like started at the beginning, but I love that they give suggestions as to how you can make them. So yes, you have the normal full pattern, but they also on the back do some a quicker version. This is just the middle section you can cross stitch with some numbers, and they give you a clock design and a cushion, and this is just the middle. And I mean, this is nice that they give you suggestions. Anyway, again, left the needle just loosely hanging off it. This is how far I've gotten with this one. Anne is showing up, and this is where she meets Marilla's hand in the middle. And I started a little bit on the border, and it's looking really nice. I'm really happy with how pretty this is looking. And I'm looking forward to start working on this again. Because like I said, I love Soda Stitch. This was my only kit by them. No, this is one of the two kits. I already showed you one in my first video because I have another one in my WIP rotation. Just putting it back in, sorry. And all the other patterns I have by them are just loose patterns, no kits. Oh God, yes, this needs to go in a little further. Three more to go, four. This is the companion piece to Cozy Cup. This is also Dimensions Gold Petites Collection kit. And this is a Mother's Pride. And this is, I consider it a companion piece, I think it is, because, you know, it's a lioness in her cub instead of a tiger in her cub. And I'm not as far along on this one. I just started in the middle with the little cub's face, which for now looks really dark compared to the, I don't know if you can see this. Yes, looks really dark compared to the mock-up on the paper. But I think if I do some here that it will look better. It usually does when it comes to cross-stitch. Again, left my needle hanging off it. I don't know why I do this. I'm gonna lose needles like this, but this is a little bit short, so maybe I'll just like leave it here. Sorry, sometimes I ramble in myself. So not so far along with this one, but it's a nice stitch. Two left to go. This is by far my biggest and most daunting project in my rotation. This is also the one I'm least far on, and this is the fabric for it. It's absolutely massive. I have not even unwrapped the entire fabric. I know it's big enough, and I think it's probably a little bit too big, but as you can probably guess, this is a heaven and earth designs, and it is a supersized max color version of A Stitch in Time. And everyone knows this pattern, probably. It's by Amy Stewart. It's probably one of her best known. And I love this one. But I'm gonna die, probably, before I finish this. Because it is, I think, 120 pages. 120 pages. It's absolutely insane. I don't even know on what count I'm doing this. I think 28 count, guess even weave. Maybe it says on here. Needlework fabrics. No, this is all it says. 28 count. I'm just gonna go with 28. Either way, let me see how I'm gonna show this to you, like this probably. This is the embarrassingly tiny amount of stitching I got done. And see already the amount of threads that are hanging off. I think this is so tiny, by the way. Like, it doesn't even focus. This is how tiny it is. Maybe if I tap on the screen a little. Yes, there it goes. This is so tiny. This is insane. I cannot stitch this at night because it's so hard to see. Anyway, I'm using a parking method and it's going really slow, and the reason it is going so slow is, among other things, I'm missing a lot of the thread colors, and I don't know how this happened, but I think with max colors, which I have, this chart is 237 colors, so I guess this is one of the reasons I'm missing so much colors. Oh God, I do not know how to fold this back up. Oh, this is so big. Yes, okay, like this, and then do it like this. Sorry, I just want to have it good. Okay, it doesn't really matter. 237 colors, it's really hard to see, and I'm missing some of the colors. So for now, I've been skipping over this a couple times in the rotation because of this. But I really hope that Santa is bringing me a scroll frame. I asked for it, so I hope I'm getting one so I can put one of my hates on it. I don't know if it's this one, because Whoops, I destroyed this bag now. Well, I don't know if it's this one that's going to be on there because I have three. I already showed you QS Alice in the beginning by Hannah Lynn. And I'm going to show you one more for my last WIP. I think this has the most chance, like the next hate I'm going to show you has the more chance to go on the frame. But this is definitely one I hope to finish in my lifetime, but I don't think I will. But it's so gorgeous. It's absolutely amazing. And I think it will look amazing when it's ever finished. Yes, I'm back to normal color. So, one, almost the last one. This is the one but last. This is another kit by Bothy Threads, and this is a dictionary bears, and this is no longer available, I think, normally in stores. So this is, I love their dictionary series. They're amazing. They're cute and they're fun, and I don't know, the wordplay is amazing. This is also a kit, and I just decided to work these block by block. So I finished two blocks completely. A bear hug and bear market, and then I'm working on the left corner block, which is in the end it will be bear necessities. And I love working on these, and I backstitch as I go on these because I just want to have full finishes. It feels like a mini finish once I finish these. It doesn't have a side border, and this kind of annoys me, so depending on how I frame it, I might copy the border from the other side to go on the right side, like here, to finish it off. And I think I'm gonna go up and do this one, and then start on the border on the top, because this is just a very long bit of the same color. I think I might do this. So do this one, and maybe then work this one. I don't know, but I want to don't leave this for last because this looks kind of boring in the end. And now we're getting to my last WIP, and I kind of want to hurry up because I'm already pushing 30 minutes. I'm sorry. I don't know why I always take so much time. Last WIP. This is also a hate. This is the very first design I bought, and it's called 12 Dancing Princesses by Kinuko Kratz. I love it. I do not know the fairy tale 12 Dancing Princesses, but this is so pretty but so dark. And I'm doing this on Magic Guide Ada in 25 count. It doesn't say on, I think 25. Okay, where is it? Where's my stitched. Okay, so I'm also parking on this one, and I think this is the one that's gonna go on my scroll frame if I get it. And also I will buy it for myself, and or my birthday is coming up too, so if I don't get it, I'll get it, hopefully get it for my birthday. But this is how far I've gotten on this one. So this is the entire top row of the page. I'm just gonna come a little bit closer so I can see. And then I started working coming down, and it looks so amazing once it's finished. It really starts to show the detail then. But I can no longer do this in hand. This is too complicated to do in hand now. So I'm hoping for the scroll frame so I can start stitching faster. So this is my very last WIP I was going to show you. So this was the end of my 25 WIP rotation. Well, not 25 anymore because it's now 24 because of my hedgehog finish. And I'm gonna talk to you briefly about my plans for the coming time. So my plan is to sign off now, because I'm gonna do some, or sign off in like 5 minutes probably. And go have Christmas, maybe work some more on my Red Barn in the coming days. So my plan is to come back to you with a new video probably on Wednesday morning, or anyway, Wednesday or Thursday, wherein I talk to you about my plans for the upcoming month, like the month of January, like briefly go over my plans, because I've decided to go a little bit more organized, I would say, into this. I want to work on some sales. I want to participate in some sales. I'm a member of the Stitch Mania group on Facebook, where most of you people know this, so they have amazing sales, and I have so many things I want to do that this is an opportunity to work on some of the things in my head I want to work on. So I'm getting hopefully some stitchy stuff for Christmas. I've asked for some fabrics and some flosses that I need to kit up for some projects I want to start. So on Wednesday, I'm going to show you whatever I got for Christmas, and then talk to you about my plan for January. And for now, my plan up until Wednesday is work on the Red Barn when I can, because I still would like to get it finished this year so I can go in to the new year with 23 WIPs. And maybe I work, if I'm getting kind of sick of the Red Barn, so I might stop it for today and tomorrow and work on my Teddy Christmas, which I showed in my previous video. Just something Christmassy. Maybe I work on that for a couple days for Christmas instead of the Red Barn, and I'll pick it back up on Tuesday. So basically this is it. I'll show you whatever I've done on Wednesday and talk about the haul and the plans. So lastly, I want to finish with some shoutouts. Most of these people I'm going to mention right now is people you already know, but the way I watch Flosstube is I pick, I started just with one of the first people that I knew, and started watching all of their videos, and then at the end, when I've watched all of their videos, I subscribe to them and give them the bell, little bell that I get an email once they upload a new video, so I keep on top of those people I've already watched. So I'm up to date with 4 people, and I want to mention Cross-Stitch Addict, Wendy. She just started floss tubing as well. I think she mentioned in her video that she'd done it before, but she just restarted it. And I really like her videos. All these people I'm going to mention, I really like their videos. The other person that just started was Gerald Ginger Stitcher. Sorry, I'm looking at my notes. I also really like his projects. I like the Frosted Pumpkin things he's working on, and just generally he has kind of a little bit of the same taste I have, which is nice. I always look for new patterns to work on. And the other one I'm up to date with is Janae from Goldfishy25, and she does monthly videos, so she just shows a lot of in one video. She does really in-depth videos too about some of her processes she goes through with how she picks threads and everything, and the changes she sometimes makes to projects she does. She's a little bit of a different style, but I really loved her Lantern Lane piece she did by Little House Needleworks. I really love how that turned out, so it's now on my wish list too. This is what we all do, enable each other to buy more things, which is very, very bad. And the last 3 people I want to mention is the Stash Queen, Katie. I'm now watching her videos. I'm at video 10, so still have, I believe, 98 videos by her to go, which I'm really looking forward to. But I'm gonna just break it up and watch some of her, and then watch some other. Kay's Cross Stitch, I'm watching her now as well. I'm halfway through. Really like her Lizzie Kate pieces she's working on. I love the Mirror Mermaid she's working on. She's doing a conversion, which I really like. I don't know if I ever have the guts to try my own conversion, but maybe someone else's conversion. And the last person I want to mention is Jessie Marie Does Stuff. I'm at the beginning still of her video, so I still have about 90 plus videos of her to watch. So I just want to mention these people. So if I don't subscribe right back to you, doesn't mean I don't want to watch your videos. It means that I put you on my Flosstube list. You can see if you're on there. This is a public playlist I made, Flosstube, and I put everyone's first Flosstube video on there. So I'm just going by that list so I don't get overwhelmed by literally probably the thousands of videos that I still have to watch from Flosstube. So I'm just gonna go gradually through them, stay on top of the ones I've already watched, and then hopefully in the next 6 months, year, I'm catching up to everyone. So I hope this is kind of clear. And by the way, if you leave me a comment down below, thank you very much. I answer each and every comment. Sometimes it might just be Merry Christmas or thank you for your comment. But if you ask a question or you say something about my work, I always answer your comment. So you can always come back and I will probably nine times out of ten I've already answered it. So if you just want to see what I say back. So your comments are not in vain. I love every one of them. And I just love to interact with people that stitch, because my family sometimes thinks I'm crazy for spending so much time with thread and fabric and getting so excited about it. The last thing I want to say is I'm going to go downstairs and probably peruse Casa Sanina some more, because they are doing a 25% off sale on everything until midnight tonight. Casa Sanina is a European site, so it might not be so handy for people living in the States. But if you're seeing this before midnight on the 24th of December, go to their website. They have 25% off on all things. I think, 25% on everything except 15% on magazines and books. But everything else, like the hand-dyed threads, the fabric, the kits, everything. Only thing is they're running low on some things. There's some things I want they just don't have right now, probably because of the sale, or they just rebranded, so maybe they're just low on stock. But there's probably something in there for you. Okay, now I'm really done, sorry. So, for everyone, Merry Christmas. Merry Happy Holidays. Have a great time with family, friends, your pets, your loved ones, your great-grandchildren, your grandchildren, your husband, your friends, like everyone. Have a great time. Enjoy your stitching if you get some time for it, but if not, it's going to be there after the holidays, and I hope you're getting all the stitchy things you wished for Christmas, and I hope you get some great time and great food and generally have a good time. Thank you everyone for watching my third video. I really appreciate everyone watching, and goodbye.